Today I will discuss about
some important polymer. At first I will discuss about the polythene. The monomer of polythene is your ethene. Remember this point. Always a 1 mark question asked in the exam, what is the monomer of polythene? Then you can write, the monomer of polythene is your ethene. Ethene is also called ethylene. Remember, polythene are two types. So you can write, polythene are of two types. Such as number one is your low density polythene, and the second is your high density polythene. At first I will discuss about the low density polythene. What is the low density polythene? These are classified depending upon the density of the polythene. If the density of the polythene is 0.92 gram per cm cube, then the polythene is called low density polythene. When ethene is heated at 473 Kelvin temperature and high pressure, that is your pressure is your 1500 to 2000 atm, in the presence of trace amount of oxygen, that is 0.03% to 0.1% of oxygen, then polythene is formed. That means we generally think about the preparation of low density polythene. Now I will want to write the reaction. This is the structure of ethene. Suppose I will take n molecules of ethene. Now it is subjected to reaction in the presence of trace amount of oxygen. Next temperature is 470 Kelvin. Pressure is 1500 to 2000 atm. Then what will happen? This pi bond will break and will able to form the polythene. This is the structure of polythene. This is a low density polythene. This type of polythenes are generally transparent, moderate tensile strength, high toughness. This type of polymer are generally chemically inert, slightly flexible, and poor conductor of electricity. Due to poor conductor of electricity, this type of polythenes are generally used as an insulating material for wire and cables. So we can write another point. This polythene is used as an insulating material for wire and cable. This type of polythene is used as a packing material in the form of thin bags. This type of polythene are used in the manufacture of toys, pipes, bottles, etc. This is some points about the low density polythene. Next is your high density polythene. If the density of the polythene is 0.97 gram per cm cube, then that type of polythene is called high density polythene. So you can write, if the density of the polythene is 0.97 gram per cm cube, then that type of polythene is called high density polythene. This type of polythene are generally prepared at a low pressure. So you can write, when ethene is heated at a temperature 433 Kelvin to 443 Kelvin and pressure, that is 6 to 7 atm. Very low pressure as compared to the low density polythene. In the presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst, that is your triethyl aluminium and
titanium tetrachloride.
Then what will happen? Then polythene is formed. Polythene is formed means high density polythene is formed. So you can write in equation CH2 double bond CH2. This is the structure of ethene, that is your ethylene. Here N molecule is taken. Now it is subjected to heating at 433 Kelvin to 443 Kelvin at pressure 6 to 7 atm. In the presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst, then what will happen? Polythene is formed. The structure of polythene is like this. Your N will be written. This is your ethene, this is your said to be polythene. Here the pi bond will be break. As a result, it is able to join the another ethene molecule and form the polythene polymer. This type of polythene, that means you think about the high density polythene, are also inert like the low density polythene. So you can write, this is also inert, but remember it is harder and more tensile and more tougher than the low density polythene. So you can write, this is also inert but harder, high tensile and more tougher than low density polythene. This type of polythenes are used for the manufacture of content. container, that is a bucket, pipe, etc. These type of polythene are also used in the manufacture of toy, pipes, bottles, etc. This is some points related to the high density polythene. Overall, this is all about the polythene. Next, I will discuss about the another important polymer, that is your polyacrylonitrile. The monomer of polyacrylonitrile is acrylonitrile, or that is your vinyl cyanide is heated at a high pressure in the presence of peroxide catalyst, then polyacrylonitrile is formed. The structure of vinyl cyanide is also called acrylonitrile, is this. This is the structure of vinyl cyanide. Now it is subjected to polymerization at a high pressure in the presence of peroxide catalyst, and heat is also given, that is your heating. Then what will happen? This fiber will bend. As a result, polymerization takes place and vinyl cyanide undergoes polymerization to form the polyacrylonitrile. This is the structure of polyacrylonitrile. Your N molecule is taken. The name of this polymer is your polyacrylonitrile. It is otherwise also called, shortly called, PAN, or also otherwise called Orlon. It has also other name, that is your acrylone. These are the different names of polyacrylonitrile polymer. There are many uses of polyacrylonitrile. The uses of polyacrylonitrile are, it is used in making blanket, sweaters, bathing cloth. Next is your carpets. There are many uses of polyacrylonitrile. Next, I will discuss about the another important polymer, that is your polytetrafluoroethylene. That is shortly called PTFE. The monomer of polytetrafluoroethylene is tetrafluoroethylene. When tetrafluoroethylene is heated at a high pressure, then polytetrafluoroethylene is formed. The structure of tetrafluoroethylene is this. This is the structure of tetrafluoroethylene. Here we take n number of tetrafluoroethylene molecule. It is subjected to polymerization at high pressure. At high pressure, also heat is given. Then what will happen? This pi bond will undergo breakdown and tetrafluoroethylene undergoes polymerization. From the polytetrafluoroethylene, the structure of polytetrafluoroethylene is this. This is the structure of polytetrafluoroethylene. It has also other name, that is Teflon. The name of this polymer is also called Teflon. Teflons are tougher and more resistant to heat and chemical attack means generally think about the action of acid and base, so you can write here such chemical attack, such acids and bases. Since it has more resistance to heat and chemical attack, so it is used as a resistance material. Now I will discuss about the uses of Teflon. First use is your, it is used as a resistant material to heat and chemical reaction. It is also coated over articles and cookware to make non-sticky. So you can write it is coated over articles and cookware to make non-sticky. It is also used in making gaskets, also used in making pump packing. Next is your valves, seals, etc. These are the uses of Teflon. Next I will discuss about the another important polymer, that is your polyamides. Polyamides are shortly known as nylon. The polyamides with amide linkage means, that is your bond C double bond O bond NH bond, which is your amide linkage, are formed by the condensation of diamines with the dibasic acid and also of amino acid with its lactam. There are different types of nylon. At first I will discuss about the nylon 6,6. The monomer of nylon 6,6 is hexamethylene diamines and adipic acid. Both the hexamethylene diamine and adipic acid contain six carbon atom. So such type of polyamides are called nylon 6,6. So this type of polyamides are called nylon 6,6. The structure of hexanethylene diamine is this. This is the structure of hexanethylene diamine. Now it is subjected to polymerization with the adipic acid. This is the structure of adipic acid. Here we take M molecules of hexanethylene diamine and it is subjected to polymerization with N molecules of adipic acid. This is one type of condensation polymerization. Here water is removed as a simple molecule. The hydrogen atom of amine combined with the OH atom of the adipic acid and form the simple molecule of your water. Your heat is given, that is your 553 Kelvin, and high pressure is given, then nylon 6,6 polymer is formed. This is the structure of nylon 6,6 molecule. It is bound to write here N. This is said to be nylon 6,6. Look at that, here 6 carbon atom present in the hexamethylene diamine, also 6 carbon atom present in the adipic acid. So the name of this polyamide is nylon 6,6. There are many uses of nylon 6,6. The uses of nylon 6,6 are, it is used to make the cord of tire, fishing net, bristles of brushes,
strings for the sports racket, etc.
There are many uses of nylon 6,6. Next I will discuss about the another polyamide polymer, that is your nylon 6. The monomer of nylon 6 is your
caprolactam.
This is the monomer of nylon 6. Structure of caprolactam is like this. When it is subjected to heating with the water, then
nylon 6 is formed.
This is the structure of nylon 6. Here you can write N. This is the structure of nylon 6. Here it is bound to take N molecules. So we can write a statement for this reaction. When caprolactam is heated with water, then nylon 6 is formed. Here we can write heat. There are many uses of nylon 6. The nylon 6 is used for making ropes, tire cord, and fabrics. Next I will discuss about the another important polymer, that is your polyester. the polyester with a ester linkage, with ester linkage, that is your bond, C double bond, O bond, O bond, this is your second ester linkage, are formed by the condensation of diols with a dicarboxylic acid, with a dicarboxylic acid. The best example of polyester is your toluene, that is otherwise called darkon. The monomer of toluene is, ethylene glycol and tertalic acid. This is your belongs to diols, this belongs to your dicarboxylic acid. When ethylene glycol is heated with the tertalic acid at 420 Kelvin to 460 Kelvin in the presence of a catalyst, then toluene is formed. The structure of ethylene glycol is this. This is the structure of ethylene glycol. Here N molecule is taken and it is subjected to polymerization with the N molecule of tertalic acid. This is the structure of tertalic acid. These two are taken at temperature 420 Kelvin to 460 Kelvin. Here we can write tertalic acid. This is the structure of ethylene glycol. There is a loss of water molecule takes place. The OH of tertalic acid combined with the hydrogen atom of the ethylene glycol, then toluene is formed. The structure of toluene is like this. This is the structure of toluene. This is called toluene, or it is also called darkon. It has also other name, that is your polyethylene, tetralate. There are many uses of toluene. First use is your, this is used for making cells of sailboats. It is also used for making water house for firefighting operation. It is also used for making conveyor beds. Next, I will discuss about the another important polymer, that is your phenol formaldehyde resin. Basically, we think about the backlight. The monomer of backlight is phenol and formaldehyde. This is an important question always asking the exam. What is the monomer of backlight? How can you form the backlight? At first, the phenol is reacted with the formaldehyde. in the presence of an acid or base catalyst, in the presence of an acid or base catalyst, then what happens? Then a mixture of para hydroxy benzyl alcohol and ortho hydroxy benzyl alcohol is formed. The ortho hydroxy benzyl alcohol undergoes polymerization to form the novalac. Then the novalac undergoes reaction with the formaldehyde to form the backlight. Now I will write the reaction. Take the thimer. This is your said to be thimer. Now it is subjected to reaction with the formaldehyde in acidic or basic medium. So here you can write H+ or OH minus as your choice. This is used as an only catalyst. This is your said to be thimer. This is your said to be formaldehyde. Then what will happen? A mixture of para-hydroxy benzyl alcohol and ortho-hydroxy benzyl alcohol is formed. The structure of para-hydroxy benzyl alcohol is this. This is your said to be para-hydroxy benzyl alcohol. And another product is your ortho hydroxy benzyl alcohol is formed. Now this ortho hydroxy benzyl alcohol undergoes polymerization to form the novalac. Now I will explain how can you form the novalac. If I will take more ortho hydroxy benzyl alcohol, then novalac is formed by polymerization. This is one ortho hydroxy benzyl alcohol. This is the another ortho hydroxy benzyl alcohol. You can take a number of ortho hydroxy benzyl alcohol for polymerization. Here hydrogen atom is present. We remove the hydrogen atom with the OH atom as water molecule. Here hydrogen atom is also present. Remove the water molecule like this. Then what will happen? You will get the novalac like this. This is the structure of novalac. Here CH2 bond. Here also CH2 bond. This is the structure of novalac. Now novalac undergoes reaction with the formaldehyde to form the backlight. This is the structure of novalac. Novalac undergoes reaction with the formaldehyde. Heat is given. Then what will form? Backlight is formed. You can take many novalac molecules. Suppose I want to explain the formation of backlight. This This is the structure of one novalog. You can take another novalog molecule. This is the structure of another novalog molecule. This is the structure of another novalog molecule. Here hydrogen atom is present. Here also hydrogen atom is present. Look at that. These are the hydrogen atom. Now I will give the formaldehyde. Look at that. There is a loss of water molecule takes place. Here also loss of water molecule takes place. Here also loss of water molecule takes place. As a result, you can get the structure of bakelite. This is the structure of bakelite. Now water molecule is removed here and CH2 connect to these two ring. As a result we can write here CH2, here OH, that is your CH2 here, next is your CH2, next ring OH, here also CH2 bond, next is your CH2, next is your again ring OH, CH2, here CH2 will be present. This is the structure of bakelite. This is the structure of bakelite. Again I will repeat. Look at that. At first phenol is subjected to reaction with the formaldehyde, then para hydroxybenzyl alcohol and ortho hydroxybenzyl alcohol is formed. Again, ortho hydroxybenzyl alcohol undergoes polymerization, gives the novalog. Now, the novalog undergoes reaction with the formaldehyde under heating condition, gives the bakelite. Next, I will discuss some uses of bakelite. It is used for making combs, fountain pens, barrels, gramophone, record, etc. It is also used for making electrical goods like your switch, plugs, etc. These are the uses of bakelite. Next I will discuss about the rubber. There are two types of rubber. One is your natural rubber. Another is your synthetic rubber. At first I will discuss about the natural rubber. The monomer of natural rubber is isoprene. It having a chemical name, that is your 2-methyl-2-methyl-butadiene. This is the structure of 2-methyl-but-1-3-diene. Now it undergoes polymerization. This is your said to be 2-methyl-but-1-3-diene. When 2-methyl-but-1-3-diene undergoes polymerization, then what will happen? Your pi bond will be formed, your one bond will empty. Here also helps to form the pi bond and here another bond is empty. That means we can write CH2 bond, CH3, here double bond is formed, CH, next is your CH2 bond. this is your said to be polyisoprene and this is your said to be isoprene. We can write a statement for this reaction. When 2-methyl-buta-1,3-diene undergoes polymerization, then what will happen? Then polyisoprene is formed. Remember an important point, the polyisoprene shows the cis trans isomerism. Now I will draw the cis isomerism of polyisoprene. At first bond CH2 group is written here, then C, then CH3, double bond C. Here it is bound to give the CH2 group. Here hydrogen atom is written because the two CH2 group present on the same side of the double bond, because it is the cis form. Again another polyisoprene is attached to this polyisoprene like this. Here CH2 group is present, here hydrogen atom is present because the two CH2 group present on the same side of this double bond. You can write the cis form of polyisoprene like this. This is the cis form of polyisoprene. Here CH2 present in the same side of this double bonded carbon atoms. Here also CH2 present the same side of this double bond. Here also CH2 present on the same side of this double bond. Because cis means the same group are present on the same side. Now I will draw the trans form of the polyisoprene. Look at that. Trans means the same group present in the opposite side. So it is bound to give the CH2 here and hydrogen atom is written here. Next I will draw the CH2 here. C double bond C. Here CH3 group is present and the CH2 group must be written here because they are opposite to each other. Here hydrogen atom is written. Next I will draw the CH2 here. C double bond C. Here CH3 group will be written. Here hydrogen atom is written. Here CH2 group is written. This is the trans isomerism of polyisoprene. All the natural rubbers showing the cis isomerism, while all the synthetic rubber showing the trans isomerism. Due to cis isomerism of natural rubber, there is an weak van der Waal force of interaction between the chains. There is an weak van der Waal interaction between chains, which resulting the coiled structure of natural rubber. As a result, the natural rubber can be stretched like a spring and it shows the elastic property. Elastic properties. The synthetic rubber also called guttapercha. Now I will discuss about the vulcanization of rubber. The process of heating natural rubber with sulfur and with the appropriate amount of the additive substance like your ZnO, that is your zinc oxide, and an appropriate amount of additive zinc oxide. Why we need the vulcanization of rubber? To improve the properties of the natural rubber. At a temperature 373 Kelvin to 415 Kelvin to improve the properties of natural rubber. Remember a very important point, the vulcanized rubbers are more better than the natural rubber. So we can write the vulcanized rubber has an excellent elasticity, low water absorption capacity and more resistant to heat and oxidizing agent. In contrast to the natural rubber, which are soft and sticky, having high water absorption capacity, low tensile strength and low abrasion. The extent of hardness and toughness of vulcanized rubber depends upon the amount of added sulfur. So you can write the extent of hardness and toughness depends upon the amount of added sulfur. Generally, in case of tire, the amount of sulfur added is your 5%. In case of ebonite, the amount of sulfur added is your 20% to 25%, and the amount of sulfur added in the battery case rubber is your 30%. Depending upon the amount of the sulfur added in the natural rubber, we can decide the hardness and toughness of the vulcanized rubber. Now I will discuss about some important synthetic rubber. First I will discuss about the cis polybutadiene. The monomer of cis polybutadiene is 1,3-butadiene. The structure of 1,3-butadiene is written like this. This is the structure of 1,3-butadiene. Now it undergoes polymerization in the presence of Ziegler Natta catalyst. When it undergoes polymerization, then your double bond is formed. Your one single bond remains empty. Here also one single bond remains empty. Your N molecule is taken. And we can write the structure of the polymer is like this. This is the structure of polybutadiene. It is present in the cis form. So it is called cis polybutadiene. You can write a statement for this reaction: when 1,3-butadiene undergoes polymerization, in the presence of Zeaglernatta catalyst, then cis polybutadiene is formed. The properties of natural rubber is similar with the cis polybutadiene. Next, I will discuss about the another secondary rubber, that is neoprene. The monomer of neoprene is chloroprene, and it has chemical name, that is 2-chloro-buta-1-3-diene. The structure of 2-chloro-butadiene is like this. This is the structure of 2-chloro-buta-1-3-diene. When it undergoes polymerization, then what will happen? Your double bond will form like this. Your one single bond remains empty. Your also one single bond remains empty. Your N molecule is taken. That means we can write like this. This is the structure of neoprene. Your N is retained. That is said to be neoprene. The name of this compound is your chloroprene. The name of this compound is your also 2-chloro-2-chloro-buta-1-3-diene. We can write a statement for this reaction: when 2-chloro-buta-1-3-diene undergoes polymerization, then neoprene is formed. There are different uses of neoprene. First is your manufacture of horses, shoes, heel, stoppers, etc. These are used as an insulator. Next is your making conveyor belt. And printing rollers. Now I will discuss about the another important synthetic rubber, that is your Burna. And The monomer of Burna N is your 1,3-butadiene, and acrylonitrile, it is also called, that is your vinyl cyanide. The structure of 1,3-butadiene is like this. This is the structure of 1,3-butadiene. 1,3-butadiene. Your N molecule is taken and it is subjected to reaction with the N molecule of vinyl cyanide. The structure of vinyl cyanide is this. This is the structure of vinyl cyanide. Both 1,3-butadiene and vinyl cyanide undergoes polymerization. When both undergoes polymerization, then what will happen? Your double bond will be formed like this. your single bond remain empty and this bond will combine with this bond, your one single bond remain as empty. We can write the structure of Bunnan like this. This is the structure of Bunnan. Here N is written, that is called Bunnan. We can write a statement for this reaction. When 1,3-butadiene, then 1,3-butadiene and vinyl cyanide undergoes polymerization, then Bunnan is formed. There are many uses of Bunnan. It is used for the manufacture of horses. Used for tank lining. These are the uses of Bunnan. Next, I will discuss about the another important synthetic rubber, that is Bunnan S. The monomer of Bunnan S is 1,3-butadiene and styrene. The structure of 1,3-butadiene is this. This is the structure of 1,3-butadiene. Here N molecule is taken and it is subjected to polymerization with the N molecules of styrene. This is the structure of styrene. Now when both styrene and 1,3-butadiene undergoes polymerization, then Bunnan S is formed. For the formation of Bunnan S, your double bond is formed like this and your single bond formed between this carbon and this carbon. Your single bond remain as empty. Your also a single bond remain as empty. And we can write the structure like this: CH2 bond CH, double bond CH, bond CH2, bond CH. Your ring is present, that is your CH2 bond. Your N is written, that is the structure of Bunnan S. We can write a statement for this reaction. When 1,3-butadiene and styrene undergoes polymerization, then Bunnan S is formed. There are different uses of Bunnan S. Bunnan S is used for automobile tires manufacture. Next is your manufacture of rubber soles, and also used for the preparation of waterproof shoes, and also used for the manufacture of belts, etc. This is all about your polymer chapter.